going to taste a very, very good wine, which is Chateau Vieux-Queue, which is from the Saint-Georges-Saint-Emilion. Okay, wow, two beautiful year. That is really legendary. A lot of argument which one is better, 2009 and 2010. Let me start with the 2009. The wine to me is really well developed already. Nice color, touch of the granite. Okay. When you nose it, you have the tobacco, bit of the tobacco, and then a lot of cherry, cooked cherries, savory character, clean, persistence, a touch of the spices as well, like the peppercorn, and as well the licorice. Lean at the aftertone. In mouth, you really get a very big, round, fruity character. But at the same time, the body structure and the tanning is still there to back it up. And yet, fresh acidity. Nice one. You can really sample it now. You can really drink it now. And then going with food, I think some nice, good piece of steak. And also sometimes you have a roast duck that go very well with it. Yeah, it's a really, really good vintage, 2009. Then we go for the 2010. Now, 2010 is the other legendary year. Or a lot of people say the classic year for bottle. To me, the 2010, I think is still young, still very young. The bouquet is not really exhibit, it's not really totally open yet. Maybe we need more time to open and decant it. It deserves to have 2 hours breathing time, or at least you decant it 1 hour in advance. And you have some very nice cherry backcurrant characters in the nose. Just start to have some spices, but it's not really fully exhibited. Now I think we need more time for the wine to really give it. In the palate, this is really complete. The wine itself, you have grapefruit agents around, but yet at the moment, the mineral character is full, the body structure is firm, the tanning is really open, but actually very, very firm. That's why you have a very high potential, and yet very great acidity, and overall balance is really complete and good in this wine. I think this wine, you can keep it for, I don't know, for the other 10, 15 years. But at the same time, you can start having this wine. You need to prepare it. You need to open and decant it. But it can go with many, many different kind of cuisine. Even the Chinese Southern Bourbon cuisine. When you talk about the freshness, when you talk about the delicacy, this wine can go with. But if you are bold enough, you can go with some really heavy, filthy, and good fatty cuisine as well. Like in the Northern, we have the Pekingese cuisine, which is really normally a little bit more fat, a little bit thicker in sauce. And that sort of things, then you can really open, drink the wine, and go with it. But the wine is really delicate. To me, I really prefer the 2010 a little bit more. But the 2009 is really approachable now, really open up, really open, and then drinkable. And 2010 to me, now you need to know the wine, you need to understand it, and then you drink it in a very good manner. Thank you.